There's different methods with using boards. The first thing to know is the boards, there's a variety of different boards. You can go from, you know, a one board, a two board, three board, four board, five board, and then I'll get into the soft boards, and I'll get into what I call the man pond here in a little bit. So each one of those boards is going to have a little bit different application. So what I want to talk about before we even get into the boards is how do you touch the boards? You know, a lot of people take that for granted. There's a lot of different things that can happen here. And a lot of people can break records off a board, but they're not really breaking the record. They just changed the way they did the press. For instance, you can use a soft touch, you can use a hard touch, you can bounce it, you can sink it, or you can pause it. And each one of those have different applications. So if it's a soft touch on the board, that means you're going to bring the bar down under control, barely be able to hear the touch, and then press back off. That's going to be used more for teaching control of the bench press, control of using a bench shirt, for technique is what that would really be used for. So each one of these methods of touching can be used to correct a different sticking point or a different problem with the bench press. A hard touch is basically slamming down onto the board. That also has positive applications. While a lot of people will argue that you don't want to do that, I would argue against that, especially with bench shirt training, or if you have somebody who lowers the barbell too slow. Keep in mind, you know, the faster a bar goes down, the faster it's going to come back up, as long as you're still maintaining control. So if you're a bench presser who lowers really, really slow, you're not going to have the reversal strength needed to be able to break your max when the time comes. You're fighting too much against the weight, and at the same time, you're increasing your time under tension. Now with a hard touch, what you're going to do is you're going to break the elbows and basically just drop onto the board. The confidence to be able to lower faster is going to be there because you have a board that the bar is going to smash against instead of your chest. So if somebody takes 5 seconds to lower a barbell, with a board, I can teach them to lower that in 2 seconds while still maintaining control, just because of the confidence that provides, that they don't feel like they're going to bash, you know, break their chest in half or whatever it's going to be. So that would be the use for a hard touch. A bounce is kind of similar to a hard touch, but basically all a bounce is there's no pause whatsoever on the board. It's just a touch and go, touch and go. The application for that depends upon the person, once again, and where their sticking point is, but the real application that I see for that method or that style of doing a board press would be if you're working with somebody who's training for the combine or somebody who wants to break an all-time record with an exercise, because that's going to allow them to get more reps within the time period before they fatigue. So with that, still all these different ways of touching still have to have an element of control. So we're not talking about radically dropping and bouncing it back up like the bars of basketball. Sinking on the board would basically mean bringing the bar down, letting it sink in, and then pressing back up. What that can do is that will actually teach, if somebody has a bench shirt, it's going to teach them to be able to relax at the bottom. By relax, I'm not saying completely let go, but a lot of times if people cannot touch with a bench shirt, they don't have the ability, when things start to get tight, to just let the bar go. So that little sink is going to actually teach them to let go a little bit so they can touch a little bit better in a bench shirt. The sinking, I don't necessarily know if it has a whole hell of a lot of application as far as non-bench shirt use. A tight pause is going to be bringing it down tight, slow, controlled, pausing, you know, for one count, two count, whatever you want, and pressing it back up. What that's going to do is that's going to teach tightness at the bottom, which is the opposite of what the sinking is going to do. So it depends upon that. That would be more applicable to a raw bench presser. So the differences with this and why I'm explaining it is you can have somebody who has just set a record last week on a two board press of 300 pounds. But when they did that, they used a tight style. They brought it down under control, they tight paused, pause for a second, and then put it back up. Now next week, they get all fired up, they hit the board, let it sink, and then heave it back up, and they end up breaking their record by 30, 40 pounds, and they think they got stronger. They didn't get stronger. They used a different style of pressing, and I see this happen all the time. J.M. Blakely was once asked, you know, what style of board pressing do you use? And his answer was fairly simple. He says, it doesn't matter what you do. If you bounce it, pause it, sink it, as long as that's how you do it for the phase that you're training that board, the whole phase, then you're going to be okay. Because then you know if you're breaking a record or if you're not breaking a record or if you just found a way. I don't want to say cheat because each one of these have a different application. But you need to understand that you may not necessarily be breaking a record because when it comes back through, say you do the two boards and then you get away from boards for a while, do floor presses or inclines or something else, and then you come back to that movement a month later and then you're weak, you're 40 pounds off. Well, you could have just went back to using the first style you used the very first time. So pay attention to what style you're using, and actually it would be better if you chose a style that was more, that was going to complement training the mini max that you do have. With the different boards, there's different, from a technical perspective, each board is going to have a little bit different technique, and it's going to change a little bit based upon if they're raw and if they have a shirt. But a general rule of thumb is, if you're using a one board, what I'll always say with that and say to the guys here, you want to stroke a one board. So a one board is going to pretty much be just like your bench stroke is going to be. You're going to bring it down, touch, and then you're going to press and then flare. Now with a bench shirt, it's a little bit different. If you go off of one board, you need to flare as soon as you leave the board, you got to start flaring. All right. A lot of times people will wait too long, and that's what ends up with the boards. That's why they end up coming back towards their face a lot of times. So I'm going to assume that bench shirts aren't going to be used. So the flare is going to happen a little bit later. But one board is basically just, you're going to, the bench stroke technique, everything's essentially just the same. The two board would be more of a flare board. So you want to flare off the two board. So you stroke the one board, flare off the two board. So the two board's right about where somebody should begin flaring, with the exception of if you use a bench shirt, which I just said is going to happen a little bit sooner off of the one board. The three board is more of a groove. So with the three board, it's going to bring it down. So you're just going to just start to hit the groove. You're not going to get to a point where the flare is going to happen, because it's going to happen a little bit lower than a three board. But keep in mind, this will change too, and I'll talk about that here as soon as I get through the boards. The four board and a five board is pretty much just a muscle board. All right, who cares how you do it? Because you don't really have time to even flare, tuck, or do any of that crap. It's a lockout board. So it's a muscle up board. So you stroke the one board, flare the two board, groove the three board, muscle up the four board or the five board.